professor, he was with three of his best students, and he told them, can you take your palm and breathe your breath? So all three took the breath and they breathed. And then the professor asked them, what do you feel? All the three were intelligent, all the three were great students. And one of them said, when I breathed, I realized how limited I am. And I breathed. And after breathing, I got stuck up. Stopped. I say, the second one was told, sir, when you asked me to breathe, I was breathing, but my mind was somewhere else. Why sir is suddenly asking me about breathing? What is this? What he wants to do? By the time it's over, sir, my mind was got stuck up with you, with what you are saying. Why are you saying? My mind was stuck up with some thoughts, and by the time it is over. And the third guy, he said, sir, when you asked me to breathe, as I am finishing one breath, I find another breath is coming. Another breath is coming. And I am living. So I see in my breath, there is another breath that is sustaining me. I see the breath that breathes me, that I could breathe. The professor said, you're set rightly. Yes, whenever we breathe, we remember that we breathe because somebody gives us the breath. But one thing all three of you missed, he said, he gives you the breath. While your breath is stopped, he continues to breathe in you. To see the world, there are so many people without breath that you could give breath. He said a story that there was a man who was coming from his court. As he was returning from his court in his car, he suddenly saw a group of people shouting near the pool of the water. He stopped the car. What is wrong? So he went inside and he saw a man was drowning, and everyone on the shore, they are shouting. Some are saying, why did this boy jump if he did not know swimming? Some others said, why are you all watching? Go and bring some rope and save this boy. Some are saying, yo, this boy is dying. But this professor, this lawyer, he heard a voice from within. You can do something. He threw away the papers. He did not even aware that he is wearing a coat. And he did not even, he just put the paper and jumped into the water. Pulled back that man. And brought him outside. That boy was breathless. And he was looking all around. People are wondering, this boy needs breath. This man had enough breath. Though he jumped into the water, he breathed him. And that boy got revived. Looked up at the lawyer and said, sir, I was dying, Thank you for giving me life. The lawyer said, boy, I saw you dying. I took risk to save you. And when you are breathless, my God told me, he has given me breath. I gave my breath to you. You are alive. Not because of me. Because someone has given me breath. So I could give that breath to you. Be aware of the one. And live in such a way that it is worth to that I have taken risk for you and given my breath for you. I saw you dying. I took risk to save you. Nobody was jumping. Now from your life, through your life, prove that it is worth saving you. That is the gratitude you can give it to me. Live your life that it is worth saving you. He went away. After some time, the same boy, he was in need of money. And with his friend's advice, as a gang, they went to the bank to steal the money. They were caught. And it was huge money. And they were given a very big punishment, supposed to be the last judgment. So the three came to the court. And suddenly this man saw the judge is somewhere he has seen. He realized he's the one who gave him life. Sir, do you remember me? The judge said, yes, I remember you. Once when I was almost dying, it is you who gave me life. Yes, I gave you life. I remember. Now I am once again in trouble. Only you can save me. The judge said, I'm sorry. I cannot do it. I gave you life that you may live with the breath of the one who gave you life. I could breathe because someone breathed, continues to breathe in me. And I saved you and I told you, live in such a way. You are dying and I have saved you. Because someone asked me to save you. I forgot about myself. I forgot about my papers. And I jumped and saved you. And I told you, live your life in such a way and prove to the world it is worth saving you. Now you are proving it is not worth saving you. You are punished. Go to the court, jail for many years. He signed and went away. Our life is a gift of God. What do we do with our life is our gift to God. Our life becomes a gift the moment we realize that I am not alone. I am because He is. I am because we are. I'm not alone. I'm here because someone has given me life. That's why in the book of Colossians, chapter 3, St. Paul beautifully tells us about the human life on this earth. He says in chapter 3, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are about, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, whatever in you is earthly: fornication, impurity, passion, evil desire, and greed. 9 onwards. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have stripped off the old self with its practices, and now you have clothed yourself with a new self, which is being renewed in knowledge according to the image of its creator. In that renewal, there is no longer Greek or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave and free. But the truth is, Christ is all and all in Christ. And live out your life.